Hello, everybody. I will talk about the study of mechanical and chemical properties stability of inner tubes exposed to gamma radiation. My name is Sandra, I am from UPenn, and this is my co-workers that collaborates with me about this work. Nowadays, car tires are not provided with inner air or tubeless. Point toward a technical evaluation, neutral trucks, tires, even used present inner tires. This is the photo if inner tires for a trunk, almost fully by a synthetic material. Currently, tires are constituted by various components besides synthetic rubber, being a product that aims to a long time of utility life. Considering that they are designed and manufactured to last under extreme physical, chemical, and thermal conditions. If present complex structure with the purpose to assign required characteristics to its performance and safe built to be indestructible. This is the photo that the tires, the components of the tires, tread, sidewall, belt plus, inner liner, bread sealer, radial cord in the beds. This study is focused by inner liner. Conventional tires that will still employ air chamber are inside to be crushed and consequently recycled. There are about 450 tires plants all over the world. Tire sales worldwide suffer a drop currently due to the pandemic, but the numbers were up size 28, where they accumulate 59.4 units. A specific inner line, a specific rubber compound, is used as an air seal inside the tire. E the inner liner has a no-cord reinforce and is a similar to an inner tub. A chamber inside the tire is composed by butyl rubber, a synthetic material having a major characteristics, elasticity and capacity to impede air leak. Air chamber is located inside the tire that does not have any extra sealing in the well to stand compressed air. The inner tab, located the inner tab, is here in this place. The valve that allows the filling is connected directly to the chamber, increasing risk and injuries caused by negligence maintenance. However, the recycling of solid residues that to a right energetic cost and during the process was just car tires. These photos shows the tire air chambers for trucker, air chamber for motorcycle, and air chamber for bike. For this study, purpose there were removed sample for production tire chambers for trucks given by manufacturers of these materials whose name is not authorized to divulge. Tire chambers received were used without any previous treatment and were characterized regarding their physical, chemical, and mechanical properties. Samples were subjected to gamma radiation 5, 10, 50, 20, 25, and 30 kilograms dose. The doses are subjected to controlled degradation for the material of the material. We use ionized radiation for cobalt source and oxygen atmosphere. For characterization, we use the CAGN elementar analysis, tensile and elongation at break, thermal aging and hardness. We use the STM norms. For elementary doors, we notice the results of elementary norms. We notice that for carbon and hydrogen, the values is very, very similar. Only the nitrogen, we notice some difference in values. Tensile in the elongation break, we notice the sample not irradiated is higher than the other samples. We notice it's causes some degradation material. For elongation at break, we notice the sample not irradiation is less than the samples irradiated. It seems the break chance season. Thermal age, this test is doing in the oven air for 72 hours. And after and before, these results show after and before aging. After aging is the black color. After, no, before aging is the black color, and after aging is red color. We notice the similar values for all the samples irradiated. For the sample not irradiation, we notice a little decrease in values for sample aging. It denotes some degradation of the sample. This is the first elongation break. The samples after aging, we notice a higher values after aging. It denotes a break of season because a little molecules has a more elongation. For the results of hardness, we notice for sample no irradiation is higher than the sample irradiated, but the values for samples irradiation is very similar. We notice a softness materials after irradiation. So my conclusion is elementary analysis did not reveal significant changes in carbon and hydrogen levels present in all irradiated and irradiated sample, indicates that even after shearing, the amount of atoms from the polymeric chain was preserved and conserved. Tensile and elongation break mechanical tests showed for irradiated sample values decreasing in function of erase in dose, suggesting the occurrence of chance season because smaller chains present smaller elongation and suffer rupture easily. Hardness result that indicates material rigidity presented low values after irradiation. This is probably caused by degradation mechanism that leads to a depolymerization, for example, weakening of elastomeric matrix caused by chance season and or erase crosslinking. So, analysis shows that it's possible to accomplish controlled degradation of truck tire chambers, considering that in doses higher than 15 kilograys occur chance season. My acknowledgments for FAPESP by financial support and IPEN and SENEM for making the analysis. Thanks for your attention. This is my email for further correspondence. Thank you.